Hi friends, I'm Jen. Welcome to the Sunshine Farm. Do you have something to say? I'm sitting outside. I'm not wearing a jacket. I'm kind of wearing sandals. Mix-matched socks and all. And I have something I want to share with you today. I want to talk to you guys about why it's not just okay to fail. It's really good to fail, and I want to encourage you to be willing to fail. And this is why. Look at this beautiful artichoke plant. It's so happy. It's so green. It's loving life. Look at this broccoli plant. It is a very strong stem. It's growing so many new leaves all the time. It's a beautiful green color. It's also loving life. And how does that have anything to do with failure? Well, I'm going to tell you a little bit about what my plants looked like last year and share that story with you guys in hopes of encouraging you to be willing to fail too. You fall again another time. Too scared to fail, you'll miss this life. My friend, just stand, get up again, you'll be just fine. My friend Rose and I were talking about how I learned so much about gardening in one season, and I was sharing with her how really it has to do with a lot of failure. So thank you, Rose, for inspiring me to make this video, and I hope you guys enjoy what I have to say. Let's go on a little walk in the garden so I can talk to you guys about last year's garden. Here I am in last year's garden. Last year, guys, I failed a lot. So I decided I wanted to have a garden kind of late in the game. It wasn't until March where I decided that I wanted to do gardening and I wanted to start plants from seed. I went onto a website called Johnny Seeds and I bought all my seeds. I had no clue what I was doing. I really was just trying to buy some seeds that were recommended to me and then some seeds that were specifically advertised as being hardy or prolific. So I ordered my seeds and then they came and I knew I needed to get planting. So not knowing anything about gardening or seed starting or where to buy seeds or what seeds to plant or what things to grow or what likes the north, any of that. I just went for it. And not only did I just go for it, but I didn't read anything except for what was on the back of the seed packet. So I went to the store, went to a country store, and I picked up what was available, which at the store, what was available was a couple of those 30 cell little square trays with the pellets at the bottom of them. And I planted my seeds. Guys, don't buy those things. They don't work well. From experience, don't do it. So I planted my seeds in those little pellets. Lo and behold, almost all of them came up and they germinated and they did great at first, or so I thought. And then they started to be super, super long and they were all falling over and I couldn't keep them alive and I couldn't keep them standing. They definitely needed more light because they were all very, very, very leggy, falling over all over the place. And so eventually when I got to potting them up into new pots, I potted them up without using moist soil. They grew super, super, super slow. They didn't have good green leaves. They looked sick. So I just kept trying. It was just like one fail after another. It was like, gosh, this isn't working. But then I began to learn. It began to learn based on what my plants were telling me that I needed to try something else. So I started learning a lot about how soil is so important for your plants and how there can be all these air pockets in the soil if you don't moisten the soil well, and how if there's air pockets then your plant's not going to absorb nutrients well, then it's not going to grow. So I'm learning all of this, but I'm not just learning it. I'm seeing my plants suffer from it through my failures. It's not just like in my head, it's in my experiences, and it was truly learned knowledge. It didn't just become a fact, it became a lesson. And so the third time I potted up my seedlings, I put them in moist soil, moist high quality soil, into pots with lots of room, and they started to thrive. Guys, we ended up with so many tomatoes from these tiny plants that I did everything wrong with. And it just taught me that plants are resilient and they are teachers. They will show you what they need if you're willing to listen. And the reason why I think my failures were so important is because I could have followed all the right steps from my head. I could have followed, you know, moistening my soil and using a good grow light. I could have started with all of those things, but I never would have seen why they matter. Why do plants need those things to succeed? And I learned why by seeing what happens when you don't have those things. And so my failures made me feel like I have so much knowledge when it comes to gardening. Last year, nobody would have said you seem like a knowledgeable gardener, at least at the beginning of the season. People would have said that you are basically a failing gardener. But it was through my failure, through those experiences of complete, utter failure, that I gained knowledge that now has put me so many years ahead of where I would have been if I had never failed in the first place. Growing up, we're trained, essentially. We are wired to believe that failure is a problem, that it's a bad thing. You go to school and you want to get those A's. Those A's are the best grades you can get, and you need to get A's in order to be able to get into a good college, in order to be able to succeed in life. The F is the dreaded, right? The F, the failed, the failure. And we learn that it's not good to fail. And I think that that's so flawed. I think that failure is really the key to growing, because if you're not failing, you're not putting yourself out of your comfort zone. You're not testing new things or trying new things or jumping into new adventures. You're playing it safe, and I think that playing it safe really leads to a pretty boring life. In the beginning of this video, I showed you my artichoke plant. Artichokes are not easy to grow in the north. They might not ever produce the beautiful artichoke heads that you think of that you eat because of our growing season and the fact that they aren't perennials in the north. They die after the summer, and so I can't get them to produce again next year. So I have to almost trick them into believing it's their second year to get them to produce those pretty artichoke heads. So the reason I'm telling you this is because in order to successfully grow artichokes, I have to be willing to fail, knowing that they're really tricky and that I might not have a plant that produces food for us. But I'm going to try anyways, because the idea of actually being able to grow a glorious artichoke is motivating enough to me to be able to risk the failure, to be able to risk the disappointment. In my garden last year, a lot of things did not thrive, especially the watermelon and the corn. We got no edible corn, guys. Absolutely zero edible corn. I think the biggest one was like this. We completely failed with corn, but I learned that the corn didn't like where it was planted. It was probably planted too close to a tree, and so it wasn't getting enough sun. And corn really likes to be planted in a block situation and not in rows. So next year, I'm going to try implementing those things based on the lessons that the corn taught me through my failures, and hopefully we'll have a much better year. The other thing about failure that's pretty amazing is that it makes success so much more glorious. If you never failed, being successful, would it be that exciting? Would it be that rewarding to successfully grow corn or to get an artichoke off of a plant if you weren't risking failure? I think all of these things are very, very clear in the garden. I think the garden teaches us these things in ways that we may not have learned before through the way things grow and thrive and succeed and through the way things fail. So I want to encourage you guys, be willing to fail. Get out of your comfort zone. Try things that scare you, try things that are new, and share your failures with those around you, because sometimes we see other people and we think, they're never failing, they're always succeeding, what's wrong with me? It brings me so much joy to have healthy seedlings because of what I experienced last year. I can't even tell you how happy it makes me to see those thick stems and standing up plants and green leaves. Plants that are going to feed us more than we experienced last year from the garden. So today I wanted to share my failures with you. I want to encourage you to embrace the potential of failure so that you can grow and thrive in ways you may not ever have expected. Friends, I promise you there's going to be some failure this year. I am trying a lot of new things. We are putting in an orchard. I'm doing a tea garden, and we're doing all of these new beds. We're trying new methods of growing, and we are planting all of these things that you might not expect to grow here in the north. Things like rice and garbanzo beans and artichokes. I'm testing the boundaries a little bit of what is possible. So I promise, guys, I'm going to share my failures with you. I'm going to share my failures, and I'm going to try to rejoice in those failures because of all the lessons that are learned that are going to bless me in years to come. And I encourage us to fail together so that we can grow together, so that we can learn together, and so that we can encourage each other to be able to look forward to all of the beauty and success and excitement that's going to result from the failures that are inevitable in a life of adventure. What's been something that you've really failed at that has taught you more than you could have learned without that experience happening in the first place? I thank you guys for being with me today. If this was encouraging to you, give this video a thumbs up and leave a comment. Share this video with a friend or two that might need some extra encouragement and some motivation to be willing to take risks. And I hope if you haven't already joined the Sunshine Farm family that you'll go ahead and hit the subscribe button so you can see all the videos we post and be a part of our farm family. We love having you guys here. Thank you for spending time with me today. I'm so grateful for all of you, each and every one of you, and the lessons you're teaching me. And I can't wait to share my next video with you guys. Bye, friends.